with your next Asia, powered by View. Once again, we would like to thank our sponsors for extending their support. We would like to take this opportunity to thank our technology partner, Akamai, digital partner Voot, knowledge partner EY, video partner Unruly, collaboration partner Dropbox Business, entertainment partner Web Talkies, new age digital partner 101 India, content partner Culture Machine. We would also like to acknowledge the support of our streaming partner 24 Frames Digital, blogging partner blogadda.com, TV partner NDTV Prime, international partner Content Asia, and the community partners Advertising Agency Association of India and the Advertising Club for their support in making this convention possible. Once again, I would like to take the opportunity to invite on stage Mr. Shrikant Khandekar to brief us about the upcoming sessions.
Okay, welcome back after the coffee break. We are going to have two sessions between now and lunch. The first is about, as you are probably aware, the coming of digital, the rise of digital video means that there is a whole bunch of new stars who have picked up following very quickly online. Many of them have been online for just a year or so and have got followers in excess of 100,000. And in some cases, much more than that. And mind you, this figure, it's a live figure. 100,000 doesn't mean anything because it's growing very rapidly and accelerating every month. The interesting thing is that, I mean, if a person from my generation doesn't recognize them, it would be perfectly acceptable. But my feeling is that even 30-year-olds in the audience may not know some of them. But for 20-year-olds, they may be household names. Okay, so the generation gap is really just a few years makes a generation, and I think that gap is getting smaller all the time. So the next session, we'll find out what makes them tick, how they picked up this following so rapidly. And 100,000 in any other medium would take a very, very long time to get, especially if you're a startup without financial support, without a company backing you. But they've got these kind of numbers. And what are the challenges ahead in there trying to grow their following? And the session after that takes the, you know, we know that it's at this point a young person's medium, and older people are getting on, as the EY presentation showed. But when you say digital video is for the young, I mean, how young? You'd never guess. One of the least realized aspects, I think, of the growth of digital video is that it is being helped along by children and even babies. If you have little kids, you will know that baby is, or that little kid is actually a digital native, has no sense of surprise that, video is available on the mobile phone. That's what they've seen since they were born. All they need to do is crack their parents' password, and that's all. They have entertainment at their hands. So the next session is about this less understood aspect of which is the segment which is growing the business. And the last session before lunch is about how to take the digital video revolution forward. What are the challenges and the technological solutions, because it is a complicated business at the back end. What are the technological solutions for mobile first markets such as India? Our speaker will address that.
Thank you, Mr. Khandekar, for the overview. As he said, our next session is how to create a following. A panel of young YouTube artists talk about what has got them so far and the challenges they face in growing their followers. For this, I would like to invite Mr. Darshan Rawal, singer. We have Jai Vijay, mimicry artist and a comedian. Ms. Prajakta Kohli, radio jockey turned YouTuber. Ms. Shalini Samuel, freelance hairstylist and founder of Not Me Pretty. This session will be moderated by Ms. Vinita Kohli Khandekar, contributing editor of Business Standard.
Hi, good afternoon, everybody. You know, I like to think that I cook very well, and my husband, my only TG so far, agrees. So I decided I wanted to become a YouTube star. And that's why I'm doing this session, to understand how do I become a YouTube star. And I've got four very different talents here. Darshan, I didn't recognize him in the speaker's room because he was smiling, because he has this sad face strumming a guitar online, and he was singing songs, and he is hugely popular. You know, I've got their stats with me somewhere. Yep. Darshan has 250,000 subscribers, or what followers are called on YouTube. There's Jay Vijay, who amazingly changes into whichever person he is mimicking. Darshan, I'm not going to ask you to sing, but I'm going to ask Jay Vijay to, because he can look like Ajay Devgan when he's talking. He can look like Irfan Khan when he's mimicking Irfan Khan, which is the thing which I found amazing about him when I saw him online. Prajakta is mostly insane, though she goes by the name Mostly Sane. But she's also hosting Vin Diesel in the evening today.
I am.
You are.
I'm not hosting him.
Well, you're, yeah, sort of. Sort of. Okay. And Shalini is your woman to go to when you have problems with hair. So, you know, one question I must ask Shalini. What happens to people who don't have long hair and don't want to go to YouTube to figure out, so who have short hair?
Yeah.
Do you have a solution for them?
So the thing is, I do want to start working on people who have different sort of lengths and textures.
Yeah.
But it's just that I've been doing it on myself for all this while, so I've been doing it on
long.
Yeah, but in, yes, I do need to cater to that sort of segment that has short hair and different hair textures.
Okay, what I'm going to do is ask each one of them to take you through their journey on how they've reached here and where they are right now, and then we'll get into a discussion with them. Darshan, you want to take off?
Yeah, hi. Hi, everybody. So I used to write songs when I was very young. So that's how I started. I was very passionate for music, and I always used to make songs. I used to make songs on guitar, and then there was a family function, or I used to go to school or college. I used to sing for my friends and my family. So always they used to ask me that, yeah, this song, that song that you have made. So I was in search for a platform where I can really put my songs and where everybody can hear the songs at once. So that's how I started. I made a self-recorded video. I kept a camera there, and I recorded a song, then a camera.
And you were based out of Ahmedabad at that time?
Yeah, I was in Ahmedabad.
Yeah, yeah.
So I had a very basic knowledge that I should put camera on three different angles and I can shoot a song. That's how I recorded my first song. Kept on YouTube, and then I called every friend of mine. Okay, now you wanted to listen to that song? That's on YouTube. You can go and hear that song on YouTube. That's
how.
I started when I was 17. Like before 4 years, I started.
So he's all of 21,
yeah,
by the way.
So that's how I started, and then people really appreciated me. I used to share them the song, and I started getting views. I started getting views, a lot of views, like 500 views, 1,000 views on my video. That really motivated me. People shared and told me that you're doing good stuff. It really motivated me. And that's how I started making content. And I always believe all the fans out there or people following me or subscribing me, I believe that they still are my friends and family. I have to present a song. And that's how I started making the songs there on YouTube. And then came a problem of financial. When I wanted to make music videos, but I had very less financials. Then I started saving my other budgets. I started making good videos out of it. And that's how my journey started with making nice videos for all the people out there who want to listen to the songs.
Okay. By the way, I forgot to ask my yes-no question. So sorry, before I come to Jay Vijay, I need to ask my yes-no question. How many of you people watch more content online than on broadcast television or linear television? Lots of green. Lots of any broadcasters in this room? You should look at the greens. There are many, many greens here. Lots of yeses. Okay? Mihir, I'm sure you're saying yes only because you have the digital video thingy. Okay. Yeah, Jay Vijay, how do you do it? And how did you start? And I mean, it's just phenomenal the kind of following you have and the kind of stuff you do. And
thank
by the way,
so much.
He's been with Shah Rukh. So King of Bollywood has appreciated him. Yeah.
Actually, I've been doing mimicry from the last, I believe, 10 to 15 years. And it's very different kind of art, I believe. People are like, mimicry is only part of the comedy only. But I don't think so. I made videos which is based on the infotainment, basically. Like today's news is based on a Samajwadi Party, so I make some videos related to Samajwadi Party. BN Purna Prasun Bajpayee as Aaj Tak news anchor or NDTV Purna Prasun Bajpayee started. जनता बदल रही है, देश बदल रहा है, देश में नोटों का बाजार बदल गया, क्या होगा आने वाले वक्त पर कहीं मत जाइएगा, ब्रेक के बाद दिखाएंगे, साथ में ही आपको बताएंगे कि प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी से डिमोनेटाइजेशन के ऊपर क्या कहा, लोग बदल गए, जनता भूखे मर रही है. एंड लाइक इफ आई विल डू लाइक इन द रवीश कुमार स्टाइल, रवीश कुमार जी का थोड़ा सा अलग सा तरीका, वो बोलेंगे देखिए चेहरा और मोहरा देखकर, हालांकि आप पहचान गए होंगे, मैं जनता का सेवक तो नहीं कहूंगा लेकिन इतना कहूंगा कि हमारे यहाँ एसी तो नहीं चलता है लेकिन कूलर की हवा जरूर आती है. लोग यहाँ पर परेशान बैठे हैं, उनसे ही पूछेंगे कि किस तरह की ये जो चीजें हो रही हैं. और मुलायम सिंह तो देख ही रहे हैं किस तरह से साइकिल फट के फटाहाल हो गई है, लोग परेशान हैं. चलिए जनता से पूछेंगे. सो
माय अपोलॉजीज टू माय नॉन हिंदी स्पीकिंग ऑडियंस बिकॉज आई विल नॉट बी एबल टू ट्रांसलेट दिस ह्यूमर इन इंग्लिश स्ट्रिक्टली. ओके या
मैम
प्राजक्ता.
हेलो, हाय एवरीबॉडी.
दैट्स प्राजक्ता ऑनलाइन, दैट्स हाउ शी डज इट.
एंड यूजुअली व्हेन आई से इट टू अ कैमरा द कैमरा डजंट से इट बैक, बट यू गाइस कैन. सो हाय एवरीबॉडी. Thank you very much. As you said, I was a radio jockey ever since I can remember. I have always wanted to be a radio jockey. I love speaking, just in case you haven't guessed that yet. And I was very excited about becoming a radio jockey, and everything was planned. I finished my studies, and then I started interning at a radio station. Then suddenly, when it all started becoming very real, I realized that I don't think I can do it, because you know, radio, it comes off really easy when you hear it. You think it's really easy. Kya karna hai? Mic pe jaake do baatein boli and you'll be good. But it's so difficult. Like, the idea of sitting in a closed room, talking to a mic, not knowing if anyone's listening to you, you know, not knowing if anyone's even tuned in, stuff like that. It's very difficult for someone like me.
You do it with the camera now. So, I mean, how?
Yeah, but then with the camera on YouTube, it's like I immediately get my views. I can see my comments. I get messages, tweets. I have that interaction, although it's digital. On radio, I had no clue. But so slowly and steadily, as I understood the medium, I was like, you know what? I sucked at it, basically. I was very bad at it. I did get my own radio show for like 3-4 months. I did it. And then if I was a listener, I wouldn't listen to my own show. That's how bad it was. I was like, nope. So that's when... I'm telling the story, God knows. Okay, so that's when... a lot of celebrities always walked into the studios. So Hrithik Roshan came one day, and me being a completely crazy fangirl just flipped. And I'm like, oh my God! Thing, I want to get a picture. And then I got a picture, and then Sudeep, who's like from Undigital, that's the network I am with right now, he met me there, and he's like, have you thought of making YouTube videos? And I'm like, no, I have a life, like, I want to earn money. So he gave me his card. He's like, okay, just in case you change your mind, give me a call. So back then I used to write blogs that my like 11 people read, you know, 12 of which were my family members. No, not a fan of jokes. Okay. So everyone. So I thought, you know what? It was like very similar to the sort of content I do on the internet. So I was like, okay, I'll start with that. I made my first video up. I got like 1,000 views, and I flipped. I'm like, 1,000 people watched my video, and then I got all these comments, good comments, bad comments. Like I kept putting out videos, and you know when you have an immediate interaction with your target audience, it can get addictive. Like as soon as you put your product out, someone tells you that, oh my God, it's great. You want to keep doing that.
And I think I did a month of YouTube and radio together, and then I was like, you know what, I think I want to shift to YouTube, and I think that's the best decision I've taken so far.
Good.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Prajakta. Shalini, not me pretty. She's not me pretty on Instagram and on Twitter.
Yep.
Not with a K, okay?
Yeah, not with a K. Hey, everyone. So, YouTube happened to me over a year back. I was a freelance hairstylist for about 5 years. And I used to, like, watch content and video on YouTube.
What's a freelance hairstylist?
So, I was not with one salon. I would go by appointment. It would be like more of a rent-a-chair.
No, I thought you had a day job and then you did this on the side. So that's what I wasn't sure. Okay, so you went to salons depending on appointment.
Yeah.
Okay.
And and then I got into YouTube. I started watching a lot of content on YouTube, and I just found no one was doing anything on hair. So me, I always wanted to obviously express myself and like express my passion and my work, but it was not with written content. It was more through like visual content, being in pictures or videos and stuff like that. So I was like, YouTube has to be the best platform to do this. Mm-hmm. I started making videos, and the best thing is like Prajakta said, the connect that you have with every video, like the time you put it up and you see so many views and you see so many comments and good comments and interaction is what sort of gets you addicted. And then when I don't put out a video, I'm like, oh my God, I'm really missing my people. I'm really missing the appreciation, like that connect with my audience. So, yeah.
Shalini's got 120,000 followers, by the way, who follow and who actually comment on the hairstyles she offers, because it's practical stuff for women when they quickly want to dress, change, do stuff.
Yeah, so my content was more relatable and realistic. So I wanted to reach out to women who want to style their hair on a daily basis. Mm-hmm. So I think easy content also kind of helped me, and nobody was really doing hair content in India. Mm-hmm. So I wanted to basically target that and make content on hair.
You know, one of the things all of you seem to say that you got response. How much does that shape you, and how much of the originality does that remove? I mean, something that I ask usually if I do an actor or a director, I ask him how much does the audience reaction shape his next piece of writing or next piece of acting. So, you know, there is finally technology at play here, there's an algorithm at play here. How much does that shape, how much does that reaction and that traffic numbers shape what you do, and how much of it is completely you're doing your own thing and connecting with lots of people?
When I started my first songs, it's all about when I write a song. Mm-hmm. So it's all about me. I'm writing a song that I love, what I feel, what I see, what I learn from the surroundings that I write. Mm-hmm. Once I put down the video and there are people who love it, mm-hmm. they say that it's a beautiful song, and definitely we all see the comments. We like to see the comments and response, what people think about that song. Mm-hmm. So there are definitely suggestions are there. This is not good, or this is very good, this is not good. And after getting so much views and comments, we definitely, when we are making a new song or next time making any content, we definitely think that, oh, I don't have to do this or people won't like it, or I have to do this, people will love it. So that's the place where I think the originality can go.
You have to balance the two.
Yes.
The pressure from the response and what comes from within yourself.
Yes.
Also, I think it's a very trial and error sort of a model with YouTube. You put your content, you don't know who's watching it, right? Everyone in the world with an internet connection and can watch you. So you don't know who's watching, you don't know whom you're targeting your content at. So I think in the beginning, you just put out everything and you take the comments in consideration, because that's how you slowly and steadily get to know, you find your feet on the channel, okay, what is my audience liking, what sort of an audience I have. So I think that is pretty important.
So when I put out hair content, no one was actually doing that, so I had no idea how it would do. But so I went ahead and put it out. So obviously it took some time. Like, it took me 6 months to understand what kind of content would work on my channel. So obviously it's, you have to be consistent, and you have to keep, as a content creator, keep making content, and then over a period of time you understand what's going to work.
Are there some particular videos which get you more followers, and then does that become a pattern that you do more of that in order to get, I mean, that's the point I was sort of trying.
Yeah, so after, what I also wanted to say is that you should always like having look into your analytics and your insights is very important to understand your audience. So for instance, if your audience is from the age groups from 20 to 30, so making most of your content, I would say like 60-70% of your content for your audience that's interacting with you mainly, you know, making that sort of content will obviously get you more views than being on trend, making videos that are trending, topics that are trending in that space would obviously get you more views.
But it might be different for Jay Vijay. Because you might do stuff which is trending.
Trending. I always go with the topics, the relevant topics. Anything. Like Sonam Gupta, I made some of the videos related to Sonam Gupta and my video goes viral. In Pakistan, in Bangladesh, in Auckland, so many people call me. I always go with, like, if I'm making a video, the people respond to me immediately. They send me a message in the text. Like, I want you to do this kind of stuff.
Whatever.
Make it something kind of the news relevant. Make it, please do Shah Rukh Khan versus Salman Khan. Because very famous faces and they are very great audience. So I always go with the content. I write firstly. Then like today's topic is something related to Narendra Modi. So I see news, I watch news and I write something about Narendra Modi and all and I make video and suddenly it goes viral.
No, but how easy it is, you know, from the outside it looks like, oh, you guys decided to do something and then you made a video and then, you know, maybe in 2-3 years.
Also, we get a lot of ki aajkal to koi bhi famous ho sakta hai.
Famous ho sakta hai, which you must.
We get a lot.
But how easy, because Jay Vijay, I remember you telling me something, will you share the kind of effort that goes into, I mean, each of you.
Every time, jaise main apne videos banata hu, main kuch face swipe karke banata hu, to people like it's very easy. I mean, you start using Snapchat and make it video. But for 4-minute video, at least मुझे 4 घंटे लगते हैं उसको बनाने के लिए. At least 4 hours.
Video takes 4 hours.
Listen, लोग जो देखते हैं, if they are giving you 4-5 minutes, तो उनको लगता है कि जो चीज देख रहे हैं एकदम वैल्यूबल होनी चाहिए. मैंने आपको 4 मिनट दिए अपने, तो आपने क्या दिए? तो मुझे उसका सडन रिस्पॉन्स मिलता है. लाइक जो नंबर ऑफ द कमेंट्स होते हैं वो पॉजिटिव होते हैं, वो बोलते हैं कि यार ये अच्छा है. फिर वो नेक्स्ट टास्क देते हैं कि आप, वो मुझे नेक्स्ट टास्क मुझे हर वीडियो में मिल जाता है कि नेक्स्ट टाइम आप ये बनाइए. सो सडनली मुझे पता होता है कि वो जितने लोगों ने देखा है वो मेरा बूम हो गए.
What he's saying is that if people are spending 4 minutes with you, they will say you've taken 4 minutes of my time, it better be worthwhile. And also he goes a lot by the comments which come across on the page. Darshan, for you?
It's a very different thing for me because I cannot just, I have to first of all live the song that I'm making. I live a song. That's a different path. That's a very artistic path where I live, I write. And then after that comes the executing part where we sit with the team, we discuss a story to make something and then we shoot it. It's a long process to shoot a music video for a day or two. We shoot it and we package it and then we bring the song. Because the audio and video, they both have to be very good. So audio, when I'm making the audio, it's a different time process. And video, it's a different time process. We both combine it and we then put it out on YouTube. And that's how it reaches to a lot of people. Because the song is going to stay with somebody throughout the lifetime. That's what I think.
I really admire the confidence the four of you have. Fantastic. But tell me, what are the big learnings, if I was to say what somebody who's attempting something like this, what could they take away from each of your experience? If you were to say 1, 2, 3, whatever the big learnings, what would you
say? I think the biggest thing I have taken away from the channel is, so before I started the channel, it's a very like basic, but it's very personal for me, so I think it helped me a lot in being the person I am right now. When I started off the channel, I was the sort of person ki, you know what, I'm not very happy with the color of my skin, or ye photo Facebook mein mat dalna yaar, isme mere pimples nazar aa rahe. I was very conscious about myself as a person. And as I went on making videos on the channel, as I went on embarrassing myself even more, just putting myself, like, right now my parameter to get embarrassed is so high. Like, there's nothing that can embarrass me. I've put so many.
Your point is just try.
Yeah,
don't
get whatever.
Cut.
But now I am this person who is so okay with me. Like, I love being me and I love my job. And I think that is, on a very personal level, that's very empowering for me. So I think this is the biggest learning I've taken from the channel.
You're in a public space, so if you're not comfortable with yourself, it's
yes, and also on YouTube, what happens is, there is no other way to crack it, there is no other way to get people to like you than being yourself. Like, aap kitne din kisi aur ko, like how long will you pretend to be someone else? Like, and a lot of times, you know what creators think is, arey, the audience won't understand. Which is the biggest blunder. The audience is way smarter than we are. So it's very, very stupid to underestimate the audience with
on that front. So okay. The audience picks it up like that. Kare yaar, so many times when I am sick or so many times when you know I'm off, I get comments on my videos saying ki what's wrong with you? You don't seem like yourself today. Or are you okay today? Or aaj ka content maza nahi aaya. You didn't put much effort. And that is true. There are times when I'm not put enough effort as I have, and they get it right every time. So the only way to be there is because you have to be you. So that I think is the biggest thing I got off the channel.
Shalini, what would you say?
So my content as till now is very different from Prajapta's because mine is more tutorial based.
Correct.
So
it's more utilitarian. It's not entertaining.
She embarrasses herself a little less than I do.
Yeah. So with my content, what helped me was obviously understanding my audience. I really took the time to understand my analytics and my insights and understand what was the age group, where did my people come from, and sort of made content for my audience, which is very important. Also, your metadata with your thumbnails, with your titles, all of that to be, your video to get come up in search is also important for somebody who's starting off also.
It's
right?
Your equivalent of ratings or box office data. You just need to study it to figure out what's working, what's not working.
Yes, I think you should take the time, probably a couple of times in the week, just go to your dashboard, understand your analytics, understand your watch time. If your watch time is 2 minutes, don't go more than 4 minutes per video because that's, you know, you need to understand how long are people
pulling
watching
down
your video for. Mm. So if you're going to make a 10-minute long video and people are actually watching for 2 minutes, your watch time is going to be low.
That's
so
right.
I think understanding the platform also where you're making content is very important.
Okay.
And obviously content is king, which is on top of the pyramid anyway. But understanding your audience and the platform will also help somebody make smart content in your space.
Super. Super. Darshan?
I feel that the first step, or anybody who wants to really start, the first step is just you have to be confident about yourself. That you have to be very confident that this is my thing, and I'm ready to portray it to the people. You just have to be confident because everything. My views are a bit different on the thing that is. I think we get smarter day by day. We do
learn
a content.
On the job.
Yes, we learn. It's a journey. But the first step is that you have to be confident about your content, and you just have to put it down because. People shooting an accident video, it's getting millions of views on internet. So people are in search of content anyway. So you just have to be very confident to put down your content. And then the journey starts from there.
Jay Vijay?
For me, I believe content should be strong. If you are creative.
But what did you learn? If someone wants to be a YouTube star, what would be your advice to them?
I believe content should be strong. Sometimes I make video more than 20 minutes, but people watch, easily watch. So it doesn't matter. I believe whatever you are doing, it should be different. Like I do Shah Rukh Khan mimicry and I can copy more than 200 mimicry. So there are so many people do the mimicry and all. So what is different in me? If I do Shah Rukh Khan and I can bet I'm the best. This is the only thing I can do. I mean,
there's nothing. Huh? You
this
have
is the
to
only
open,
thing.
Yeah.
So, I do something different in a different way. So people, that's why most of the time I use face wrap. Why? People want to see Shah Rukh Khan face and Shah Rukh Khan voice, but he's doing something different thing.
Correct.
So they admire me.
Also, I think one thing everyone will agree with, and I think all YouTubers will agree with, is the biggest thing you learn when you become a YouTuber is how to deal with hate.
How do
you get
with
hate?
Yeah.
Because you get so much hate, like people use all the freedom in the world when they're on the internet. So you get so much hate. I think that's one thing that every YouTube creator learns.
Do you get more hate than love?
No, I wouldn't say that, but there's quite a lot of hate. So now we're like immune to hate. Someone comes and slaps us, we'll smile and walk off. We're like, huh, okay, fine, all right. Okay, that went too far, but whatever, like you get the idea. Yeah, I would slap him back.
But why, I mean...
It's just an open platform. Yeah, of course I do face negative comments, but it's okay. You have to take it with a pinch of salt. If you're getting good comments, you get bad comments. Just ignore it. It shouldn't bring you down or whatever. But I think what Digvijay said that having different content obviously makes a big difference because people are hungry to watch content, and if you can bring something different on board and make good video but which is different, I think that will also take you a notch up higher. So people shouldn't be afraid of making different content. If it's
don't be afraid, be yourself,
be yourself, don't
learn to deal with hate. And how do you deal with
actually,
the business part of it? How do you make
hate
money
on the job?
Yeah. That's true for most jobs.
Yeah.
Yours is perhaps more in your face.
Ours is like right there, like hello.
Yeah. And I think social media lends itself to a lot of nonsensical
stuff. But you know what? It's
stuff.
Also fun.
Yeah.
A lot of times.
Maybe.
Yeah.
It is. Yeah. But what about the business side? I mean, how do you guys sustain? Where do you make your money from?
Let's talk to the richest YouTuber on the panel.
Okay, Darshan, you're a good Jew. You have to be the richest guy on the panel.
Income tax.
No, nothing. I'm just saying that, yes, when we make original content. So I have just one or two content that are not original. After that, every content was original of mine because it made me earn money. So YouTube has, when you get views, definitely views, and there's an ad going on your videos. So it gives you a certain
revenue share. So is that enough to sustain, or do you have to do live shows and stuff? I mean, especially for people who want to attempt this space.
YouTube primarily, once it sets the ball rolling, the money is good, eventually. Also,
at what follower levels?
So how YouTube basically, I'm sure a lot of you guys already know it better than I do.
Yeah, they analyze the business, so many of them.
Yeah. So there's not one number you can ever put your finger on.
Okay.
Haan, 20,000 views aaye to itne paise kamaloge.
Achcha.
Because there's different ads, different clients have different understandings financially with YouTube, there's different revenue share. So there are times when, you know, 10,000 views make you as much money as 50,000 views sometimes. Depends on the ad. Like, it's just a very random figure. That's then again, you get a lot of brand deals on YouTube because a lot of brands spend a lot of money in digital marketing. And a lot of times you have YouTubers, you do a lot of brands.
Shalini
a lot of
has the maximum potential for brand integration.
Because the beauty and hair space is such that you will get a lot of brand deals. If you're an influencer and you have a certain amount of numbers, and obviously brands will reach out to you, you know, if it's a sponsored video, pay you for the video, give you products, or if it's just products, just for review. So. Beauty and hair space has a lot of
me and Devijay are the poorest.
My aim afterward gets that I'm getting so much love and so much people out following me, so then it gets converted because the content that I really make is like, it gets the,
so love is money.
Yeah.
So audience love is money. Okay, please note that. There is so much content online, and Janine and I were talking about it. The discoverability is such a big issue. How do you tackle that? And that's my last question because we'll be running out of time then. But how do you get discovered? How do you get people, does it happen organically that word of mouth get through, people go? I mean, when you first went on in the first 6 months, how do you get discovered? Why did One Digital or whoever find you on? How did that happen?
With me, it was very much I made a video. And I kept it on YouTube, and my friends started sharing it. They told, they really liked the song, they told their friends told somebody else. And that's how the amount of people watching the video grew larger with every song. Then it was, I got really famous regionally, and then it was on national level. People started, if I have a friend, if I like something, if I have a friend in Udaipur, I'm sharing something to him, he is sharing that content to many of his friends.
It's and basically word of mouth.
Yeah, word of mouth.
Also, I think on when you start off with a YouTube channel, you don't have money for publicity, for marketing and all of that. So the best thing to do when you begin is just be shameless about it. Just tell your
promote
family,
yourself.
Just tell your friends about it, that here's my channel,
is
subscribe to
my channel.
Is
anybody noting down these tips? Okay, good. Thanks, Janine. Lovely.
Yeah, so like subscribe to my channel, share my video, you know, stuff like that. There have been, I have pestered friends. People have taken me off their Facebook. Like, I have done so much. Like, I've literally gone to people
them.
Like, hi, subscribe, and they're like, stay away from me. So I think that is also very important.
And we
thing.
Still do it.
Yeah.
We tell people, please comment, subscribe, like.
Yeah, still now on every video and going forward, we'll always keep saying this.
Okay.
It's never going to stop.
Shall we? Anything you'd like to add?
So I think for me, what really worked in terms of getting searched was good metadata. So I researched on what title keywords will work for my space. In beauty and hair, which were the most trending, which were the most searched. And that sort of gave my videos a way to come up in the first 10 videos, you know, in on YouTube. So I think your title keywords to get searched is very important. Then obviously understanding your, the two things which I can take through my journey was insights, your analysis,
your data,
and your metadata. And your title keyword is, you should put in time to understand.
Jai Vijay, aapko dikkat hui shuru mein to get people to discover you?
मुझे शायद कभी प्रॉब्लम नहीं
हुई. गुड.
मुझे
कंटेंट ही
मैं क्योंकि मेरी जिंदगी में मेरे पास एक ही चीज है, वो है शाहरुख खान. व्हेन पीपल सर
समथिंग बाय द वे ही डज मोर देन हाउ मेनी 200 और
200 मोर देन 200
सो इट्स नॉट ओनली शाहरुख खान, सो ही इज यूज्ड दैट एज एन एग्जांपल थ्रू आउट.
सो बेसिकली जितना 200 वॉइसेस, यस आई कैन मिमिक मोर देन 200 पीपल. सो मुझे वहां से थोड़ा लोगों ने अप्रिशिएट करना स्टार्ट कर दिया. मुझे लगा यार इतनी दो महीने में मेरे पास मोर देन 50,000 लोगों ने मुझे सब्सक्राइब किया, तो मुझे लगा ये कुछ ज्यादा ही तेजी से जा रहा है. तो मैं थोड़ा चीजों को लेकर थोड़ा सा सीरियस हो गया. मुझे लगा नहीं, अब ऐसे करना चाहिए. अब मैं
बहुत सारे लोग देख रहे हैं, आई माइट एज़ वेल
बी केयरफुल. रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी बढ़ जाती है. कुछ लोग बोलते हैं कि तू झूठ बोला, ये शाहरुख खान तू नहीं बोला, तूने पीछे डब स्मैश लगाया. तो आई फील वेरी गुड कि यार इनको ये बिलीव नहीं हो रहा कि यार मैं हूँ, ये शाहरुख खान की मैं निकाल रहा हूँ. या फिर ठीक है, लर्निंग प्रोसेस अच्छा था मेरा.
ओके, आई एम ऑन माय लास्ट 8 seconds, सो दिस इज व्हेन आई आस्क यू द लास्ट सेकंड यस नो क्वेश्चन. Is it easy to become an online star? Yes or no? I love it. You plot them. They say no, it's not easy to become an online star.
All the green cards meet me outside. You, I'll turn you into red.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much.
By the way, there's one little thing.
Thank you.
Instead of giving you boring mementos, which are metal and things which you throw in the bin, which I usually do after I've spoken somewhere,
sorry. No, we don't.
Anybody
don't
who's called me to a conference is here. They've clicked pictures which we will be getting as mementos for us. So,
awesome.
So, you know, that's the whole...
Already?
Awesome. Yeah. So, they've given us our picture.
That's the content.
But see, here I can't see the picture and reject it.
So, the takeaway is love is money. Here.
Well, thank you YouTube stars for this fantastic and interesting session that we had with you guys. Can you please have a huge round of applause for them? I think they were fantastic. Thank you so much. Thank you once again for joining with us.